This video will contain my opinion on certain songs. So, just to make sure I don't get too off track talking crap about all these things, I'm bringing out the correct opinion hat. The correct opinion hat, everyone. All this hat does is just affirm that I have the right opinion on everything. So if you find yourself struggling on, should I like this song? Should I not like this song? Just keep in mind that I have on the hat that says, this guy speaks some truth.
Hello, my dudes and female dudes. That intro might not stick, but hopefully this new series will. Man, that was just a seamless transition there. It is called Christian Complains About Christian Things. This may be the first and only episode of this new series. You may notice it looks a little more negative in the title. That's because commentary inherently is a little bit critical of other things. Let me state first that I love worship music. Love it. Got my own playlist on Spotify called Jesus Jams. And are there some spicy ones out there. However, comma, with the good, there's also the very bad. And today we're gonna talk about what I consider are some very bad worship songs.
Well, without further ado, why don't we just get right into it? Here are some Christian songs that suck. So for the first one, we're going to talk about one that was huge for so long and is actually the reason why I remembered that I wanted to do this video. Good Good Father by Chris Tomlin. Love, 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 you're a good, good father. Who you are. Ooh. Sorry about that. I got just so immersed in how catchy the chorus is. With Good Good Father, it's been a while since I've actually heard that one. But in its prime, let me tell you, I did not like it. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. But I've known we're all searching for answers only you provide. Amen, brother. Amen. You're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Are you noticing a pattern? Because I sure am. My big issue with most of these songs on this list is going to be repetition. My issue with repetition in worship songs is not that they're repeating good lyrics. It's just that it starts to feel really brainwashy. It just feels like everyone's trying to trick your mind into saying things over and over, and then all of a sudden you just believe it because you've said it so many times. Also, I don't really think it sounds that good. It's not that every song that I go into worship with has to sound good to me, by any means. But it's so droning. Does it not put anyone else to sleep? I have to admit, I like the bridge of this song. That little part sounds good to me. But again, it's just, it's just so boring.
Number two on this list to your mind was a song that I pretty much wanted to add to this list about the second or third time that I'd even heard it. And it is King of My Heart. Now, everyone and their mother has led this song in worship. This song is a lot like Good Good Father, especially in the sense where it has lots of time saying the word good. Now, with all these songs throwing out good as far as God goes, you're going to start thinking, well, Kyle, do you not think God is good? And I do. I do. I do. I swear, why do you keep asking me? While I think God is good, I do not think this song is good. The biggest glaring issue to me is just the fact that the chorus just says, you are good, good, oh. You are good, good, oh. This song drags along like an animal who has been shot in both legs. A deer. Don't forget that I said animal. A deer. A deer that's been shot in both legs. And the deer's effort gives an uplifting vibe. I get uplifting vibe from this song. But the rate at which this song drags, it just makes you want to put it out of its misery. Okay, that might have been a grim way to say that, but I think you get the sentiment. Now, there's very little lyrical content to this song. I think that the words that they do say are good. Good. Oh. I think instead of coming off of simplistic, like I think this song was going for, I think that it just comes off as lazy to me. I guess I just don't get the two goods. Like, good, good father just said, good, good father a bunch of times. This song says, you are good, good, oh. Why not? You are good times a million. It's who you are. That might be more accurate. Good times a million, holy crap. Maybe even more than a million. Good times infinite. Yeah, of course, I'm just making a goof when I say that. It's just, good, good, oh. Has to go down as my least favorite, laziest, and worst chorus ever. Ever. I don't think I've heard a worse chorus. And it also, I mean, all versions of this song take forever. This is one of the shorter versions, and it's 6 minutes 30 seconds. I could listen to two dope songs off Jesus Jams in that same amount of time. Get a lot more words, too. Okay, anyway, I think I've murdered this song enough. I mean, doesn't even really deserve it. It's just annoying. This next one is actually, man, I'm casting a big net with this one and talking crap about not just really one song, but a whole lot of songs. But I'm gonna use one song in particular to spearhead this argument. I so dislike this next song. So dislike it. This is one of my least favorite Christian songs of all time. Mandisa with Overcomer. You're an overcomer. Let me say before I just absolutely tear into this song that this song has freaking 28 million views just on YouTube, and it got played just about every day of the last year that I listened to Christian radio. So I just say that to say Mandisa, all of these other people that I brought up, they are doing just fine, my dude. So in the end, I don't feel too bad about tossing some criticism their way. Okay, so, oh dude, I'm just remembering how bad this song is. It's got a good message. It's got a good message. Let me get that out of the way. That's my positive. Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by, T-Mac on the radio. She's already thrown out T-Mac on the radio. Does anyone else feel cringe about that? Maybe not. Maybe I'm just overreacting. Name dropping in a Christian song already just really rubs me the wrong way. I'm sorry. See, and now in this video, they gotta throw out, like, it has a meaning to it. It's talking about a woman that has, you know, lost her ray of hope. And that part, I mean, makes me feel a little bit bad about, you know, talking crap about the song. I mean, let's look past that. That's a good message. It's good to give these people the light. I love it. Love that. Let's keep going, though. Whatever it is you may be going through. Scientists say that 9 out of 10 songs in the CCM genre have the same beat. No, I'm just messing around as far as that goes, but, I mean, it's just so cheesy, and it's like the complete opposite, actually, of the last set of songs that I showed. Whereas they dragged along the bottom of the ocean, those songs were excruciating in that way. This one is the complete opposite. You're not gonna let this get the best of you, you know, you got this. I feel like I need to say it again, good message. But the way it's delivered is just so, processed. It's so generic. To me, it shows a lack of passion. This may be looking too deep at it, but it also kind of furthers the rhetoric of God is your best friend. He's going to orchestrate everything to work out just for you as long as you just overcome it. While I do believe that God cares about the individual, I think it's beats and messages like this that encourage this individualistic sort of style of life almost. I could be completely misreading that. That's just what I get from that. The biggest thing for me is the cheesiness and the lack of passion in this. Does this song, Mandice is a good singer, this is a good message. Does it deserve 28 million views on YouTube? Probably not. I'll tell you why it did get 28 million views on YouTube. It's because this song was played relentlessly. And I don't think that's Mandice's fault. But I think this song really signifies a bigger genre. And that is the genre of CCM, as I mentioned earlier. Now, CCM, if you're not familiar with it, stands for Contemporary Christian Music. I don't want to cast this big umbrella statement like CCM is all bad and all just super cheesy, upbeat, poppy type stuff. It just frustrates me because I feel like so many people that come to faith, they're like, okay, I'm a Christian now. Now I have to listen to CCM. And that is just not the case at all. I hope that no one gets too offended by that. I recognize it as a blanket statement, but, and man, if you vibe to something like this song, if it encourages you, please keep listening to it. Keep listening to it. But understand, please, why I think it's bad. It's repetitive, it's cheesy, and it sounds horribly, horribly processed. I think those are my big points with that, and really the whole CCM genre. It's just not for me. Moving on, I wanted to end on a lighthearted note. I guarantee none of you have heard of this song. Well, you know what? I won't even say that. It has quite a few views, I guess, but this song is by The Order of Elijah, New Line of Defense. Brace your ears, everyone. I know right off the bat that a lot of y'all are already agreeing with me that this is crap because a lot of people don't like metal music. However, I would encourage all of y'all to check this video and song out just for the sake of laughter, if nothing else. So yeah, watch this video and tell me you don't get like a seizure from these camera movements right at the very start. So you can automatically see this is very ambitious filmmaking here. You keep the camera still like I have it here, and you can just digitally just... You'd have to zoom it in a little bit, but you can go... I don't have motion sickness, but I did want to throw up just watching that first part. Now is the time to come alive! Okay. I love the hand movements, dude. Just... He looks like... Oh my gosh. He looks like... He looks like in the Pink Panther movies. He looks like Jacques Clouseau in the first one. Where they're trying to convince the guy that they're like dancers for the ballroom thing. That's what he looks like with his hand movements. That glass effect, dude. When was this made? Oh, it was made same year as Overcomer. Those are some effects from about 2008. Basically, the main attraction here and to why this song is so bad is, well, one, because of the music video. I mean, I couldn't help but show this. But also, the lyrics are pretty interesting. Okay, the best part of the song, though, guys. I really hope you've been listening to this part, because this is the part I wrote down this song on the list, and I was like, oh, I cannot wait. Okay, now we are the Order of Elijah. We've been coming at you straight up with a savage mindset of glory. I'm gonna take a second to demonstrate how we do things in the underground. Now watch me as I burn this world. Oh, we are the Order of Elijah. We be coming at you with a straight up savage mindset of glory. Now watch me as I burn this world down. Don't burn the world down, man. Please? It has a lot of self-glorifying undertones. I mean, there's so much wrong with it, but I cannot help but just love that. Okay, anyway, I don't have too much more to say about that song. It's just, it's a bit of a goof. With that last one, I just want to thank you guys for making it through the whole video if you did. Let me know if you disagree or agree with any of the points that I made, any of the songs that I like, or you feel like I missed out on. Be sure to give me more things to gripe about in future episodes of this if you want to see some more. And of course, on that note, if you do want to see some more, make sure to give me a like or a dislike. Either one goes a long way, and I super appreciate it. Just like I'm criticizing these guys, feel free to criticize me. I think we can all stand to grow. Just maybe be nice to me. I don't know. My feelings get hurt pretty bad. Let me know what you think, and until the next one, I'm Kyle, and I hope you enjoyed my video. I'll see you in the next one.